Middletown is one of the neighborhoods that I think is perfect for a date night because there are so many dining and bar options, including entertainment options, all within walking distance on Wells Street. In fact, I'm going to hit up some old school dining options in Old Town. Talk about a fantastic date spot in Old Town. I'm talking about Orso's. It's old school and third generation, part of the family, Sienna. Yeah. Tell us about the restaurant.
45 years we've been here. Just classic Italian-American. It's a huge spot where we have our patio that we're sitting on now, and we have gorgeous chandeliers, pictures for celebrities and news anchors and policemen throughout Chicago, so it really does pay homage to what Chicago is.
It's not just a beautiful patio, but you have all these vines that create like a roof.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Would you say that Orso's is one of the best romantic spots in the city?
Oh, hands down. 100%. You can't find another patio like this. It really does take you to Italy itself.
And tell me about some of your bestsellers.
Bestsellers, definitely lasagna, are going to be all our classics. Spaghetti bolognese. We have our jalapeno gnocchi, which is highlighting the new age, the new school with the old school, classic Italian.
What makes Old Town so special?
Even though development lately has been a little more new school, introducing more bars and whatnot to us, we still have those hidden gems and hidden pockets that keep the tradition alive for Old Town.
I'm here with Ian. He is the executive director of the Old Town Merchants and Residents Association. Hi, Ian.
How are you?
Okay, so we're at Kamahachi. One of your favorite places?
Yes, indeed.
Why?
I think that this is, first of all, it is third generation owned by women. It's also the first sushi restaurant in Chicago, which is pretty fantastic. This neighborhood is one of the oldest in the city. A lot of the buildings here have actually survived the Chicago fire. And then you see a lot of variation in the architectural style.
So we're right across from the Fudge Pot and the Doghouse Grill and Old Town Aquarium. They've been around a long time too, right?
They have. The Fudge Pot is currently about to change ownership over to third generation. So they've been around since 1963.
And then the Old Town Aquarium is a shop that's been around a long time too,
it's
I think,
been around
right?
for a long time as well. I mean, the sign is really, really iconic. I've had so many people that come into the neighborhood and say, I didn't realize that you had like a free aquarium. I mean, you could go in there and see a variety of fishes that you wouldn't normally see at a pet store, but it is definitely a pet store.
Let's talk about the theaters. You've got Zany's, Red Orchid Theater, of course, Second City.
Exactly, yeah. So Second City is probably one of the most important comedy theaters in Chicago and also in the U.S. If you think about how many big names have come out of Second City, Gilda Radner, Tina Fey, Amy Sedaris, Stephen Colbert. Zany's is probably the premier place to see stand-up comedy in Chicago.
And Red Orchid Theater is
Red
right
Orchid
there.
Red Orchid Theater is right here, yes. They've been in the neighborhood for a couple of decades now.
Hi, Jean.
Yes.
Hi, Ian.
Oh, my goodness.
This is my mom, Sharon. Aww. And we've been on the street for 50 years, so we represent one of the many multi-generational businesses here in Old Town. We just love the sense of community that we have that I think no other neighborhood has. If you want to borrow a cup of sugar, it really feels just like that.
Mary Kay, Twin Acres, cult following, neighborhood staple.
Yes.
How did you get involved?
So my family, we're celebrating 40 years this year of ownership of Twin Anchors.
What are you guys known for?
We are known for our barbecue ribs. So ribs are the specialty. We've been serving them since 1932. We also have pulled pork, we have chicken, we have wings, we have burgers. We have your favorite, the shrimp, which look like little mini lobster tables.
It's my favorite, yes. I love it. I mean, I go to a place that's known for ribs for shrimp, but yes, it's really good. What makes Old Town so special? And why does Twin Acres work so well there?
The building dates back to 1887. It was a neighborhood tavern as far back as at least the 1890s. The bar that we have in there now has been there since 1917. What's fascinating about Twin Acres is the generations of people that have been coming here. And I have people who come in and tell me that, oh yeah, that booth over there, that's where my grandparents got engaged. I mean, there's just so much history and legacy. It's a family. Twin Acres is all about family. It's about family with the customers, it's about family with the employees, and that's what makes it so special.
So it's been a day full of oldies but goodies here in the Old Town neighborhood, and I'm going to end my night with another one with a